Good morning, all of you. So we'll continue from the last class. So as we know that we have studied in last class, what is the respiration in human beings? So from the nose means nostrils to how the air will reaches to the air sacs, or else we used to call it as alveoli. So till there we have I have already explained you in the last class. Is it yes sir?
Yes sir.
So, but even yesterday I have asked some questions that what is the another name of voice box? What is the another name of alveoli? But so many have written wrong, particularly Arya, Athena, you all people has written wrongly. So that is what I am saying you, be very careful. So once again, we'll make it, we'll continue that process. As we know that air, it is entered from where? Air is entered through?
Nostrils.
We have called as nose. So nose, we have it two holes called as nostrils. So after nostrils, the air is entering to a nasal passage, or else we used to call it as nasal cavity.
Nasal cavity.
So here, this buccal cavity and nasal cavity has been separated by one kind of a bone called as bony pellet. Is it yes, sir?
Bony pellet.
Hard bone.
Yes, correct? Sir.
So on this nasal passage, this nostrils, we have a hair. We have a hair and as well as we have a mucus. So this both, what they will do? They will stop the dust particles and other impurities which should not enter into the nasal cavity or else nasal passage. Means they will filter the air and they will send the clean air to the lungs. Is it yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So after nasal cavity or nasal passage, the air is entering into the pharynx. So from the pharynx too, it will start entering into the where? It will start entering into the a main part are called as what? Windpipe, or also we can call it as what?
Trachea.
Arya, yesterday you have written wrong. Everybody, Dina also, please make a call fastly for them. So, windpipe. Now, after windpipe, so this windpipe, above just we have some part which has been shown here, little bit bigger. So that is what we should call it as what? Voice box.
Voice box.
Also, we can call it as what?
Larynx.
You have to remember that this all the names you should remember. You are not supposed to commit any mistake. So now windpipe, if you're coming to here, so windpipe has been separating into the two separate branches. So that is what we used to call it as branches. What we should call branches.
Branch.
This is one branches and this is one branches. So the plural form of branches is what?
Branchae.
What?
Bronchi.
That is so. And if you observe, this windpipe has been covered with some kind of a soft bones, rings kind of structures, which we used to call it as what? A rings of cartilage. Only called as what?
Rings of cartilage.
So the main function of cartilage, Pranav, you have written very simply. Do you understand? One line. At least you have to explain like a little bit bigger line. So what is the use of cartilage we have? The cartilage is what? It is the soft bones which we used to call it as cartilage, which does not collapse even when there is no windpipe. If there is no air, it does not allow the collapsing of the windpipe even though it does not have air, because of it has been supported by whom? It has been supported by rings of soft bones, which we used to call it as what? Cartilage. Do you understand it?
Cartilage.
What you should remember. That is the importance of rings of cartilage in our windpipe. The windpipe has been surrounded by these rings of cartilage, because if there is no air in this windpipe, then it has to be crushed, but it will be prevented because of these rings of cartilage. Do you understanding all of you?
Yes,
so later this windpipe has been separating into two smaller tubes called as branchi. Understand? B-R-O-N-C-H-I. That is what we used to call it as branchus, and another branchus, both we used to call it as bronchi. Understand? Plural form of branchus is branch. So now
Anki.
here, the air is entering into the two different lungs. We have a two lungs we have. So it has been entering into this one. And we have a small tubes here. We have a small tubes. This small tubes is called as what? Branchiole. What we should call? Branchiole. Understand? And at the end we have a flower like structures, so that is millions of alveoli are present. This alveoli is the place where the gaseous exchange takes place between blood. And carbon dioxide gases exchange in this air sacs. So yesterday I have asked you what is the another name of alveoli. So many has written alveolus or singular name they have written. It is not. It is called as what? Air sacs. And down we have some kind of a thin layer of muscles which we used to call as what? Diaphragm. And this one we used to call it as chest cavity. What we should call? Chest cavity. Okay, chest cavity. What is another name of chest cavity? That is also most important. Chest cavity.
Thoracic cavity.
Yesterday, this is I have not asked, but you have to remember. Thoracic cavity, another name of this. Second names is most important. Please remember all of you. Second names is most important. So diaphragm is made up of what? Diaphragm is made up of a sheet of muscles. What is that? Sheet of
muscles.
This is what I have taught you till last class. Correct or not? So the process you should remember: nose, nostrils, nasal passages, pharynx. Next one, windpipe. Next one, bronchus. Next one, it has been entering into a branchiole. And finally, it will reaches to alveoli. Or we used to call it as air sacs. Do you understand?
Air sacs.
Yes or no? That is what respiration process in human beings. Now it is half process. Half process is completed. Means the air is exchanging. The oxygen is exchanging between air and blood. At which part? Where the oxygen will be exchanged? The alveoli, where the gaseous exchange will take place. Till there we have studied. Is it yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
As we know that we have enough surface area of to exchange the oxygen gas required to meet the body requirement. That is why, as we know, if you will exempt this alveoli from these two human lungs are unfolded, if you will make it spreading, then it has been forming a area of about how much? Area of about
80 square meter.
Yearly understanding, which is square meter, 80 square meter, which is equal to how much?
Tennis court.
Understanding? So, what you are remembering till here, I have taught you. Is it true or not? Yes. So now,
Yes, sir. Here
we have a bottom between the abdominal cavity and the chest cavity. We have a sheet of muscles called as what we should call diaphragm. Is it yes or no? Nobody will respond.
Yes, sir.
Here below, if you come, we have a abdominal cavity or else stomach. We have this part below, we have a stomach, and this is called as chest cavity or thoracic cavity. Middle, we have a sheet of muscles, which we used to call it as what? Diaphragm. This diaphragm and as well as the muscles which has been placed in between the ribs, rib cage, will be useful to help in the expansion of chest and contraction of chest during breathe in and breathe out. Is it yes? So the diaphragm is a sheet of muscles just below the lungs It helps in breathing in and breathing out. Is it correct? So the muscles of chest means where it has been present between the ribs and as well as this diaphragm, they only will be helping in breathing in and breathing out. That is the mechanism which we have studied last class. The mechanism which has been involved in breathing in and breathing out. Is it yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So, when we breathe in air, what is happening? The diaphragm and the muscles attached to the ribs, they will contract. Is it yes or no? What is the direction? Anybody please tell me. What is the direction? Last class I have taught you. Please remember and tell me. They are contracting, means how they will go. Ribs, how they will go. And diaphragm, what is the direction? To increase the size. Breathing in, please. Those who are remembering, let me tell you.
Upwards and outwards, sir.
Yes. So when the muscles present between, Dina is saying the diaphragm moves downwards. Wrong, Dina, you are saying upwards. The diaphragm moves downwards and the ribs, the muscles of ribs will go upwards and outwards. Is it yes or no?
Outwards.
Upwards and outwards.
Yes, sir.
So that the chest size is increases, the ribcage size is increases, so that the air will go inside. Is it yes or no? So the same way, again I'm saying you, all of you don't get confused. Breathing time, we have it two things must work. That is, one is the ribs, the muscles which is attached to the ribs and the diaphragm, both they will contract. Contract means the sense of the diaphragm has been pushed down and rib, the muscles which has been attached to the ribs, they will moving upwards and outwards. So that what is happening? The chest cavity expands. So this expansion movement of this chest increases the volume inside the chest cavity. So due to this increase in volume, the air pressure decreases inside the chest cavity, and from outside, understanding, having much high pressure, so that it will be rushes into the lungs through the nostrils, trachea, and what is the one more part important? Nostrils, trachea, and what it is? Bronchi. What we should call?
Bronchi.
So bronchi, it will reaches to the where? It will reaches to the alveoli. Is it yes or no? Is it yes or no? That is what you should remember. Now, in this way, during process of breathing in, the air sacs are used to called as alveoli. Arya, I am saying you, and Dina also. Yesterday I written wrong. Alveoli used to called as air sacs. So, in this way, when the outside air pressure is much and inside air pressure is less, as we know, sir, how you are saying, where the pressure? This is the most important question which is to come. When we are breathing in, where the air pressure is more, inside the chest or outside? Inside the chest or outside? Outside. Do you understanding? Because as we know that we have studied lower classes or ninth class also, if the area increases, pressure will decreases or increases? If area increases, pressure will decreases or increases? Pressure is equals to force by area. Pressure is inversely proportional to area. You may remember. Please let me know. How many of you know that?
Sure.
So, relationship between them, you have studied in lower classes. So, you know that pressure is equals to, it belongs to physics. Now, pressure is equals to force by area. So, now you can see here, pressure is directly proportional to 1 by area. Means, if area is increasing, pressure will decrease. If pressure will increase, area will decrease. Is it yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So, here also in our case of our chest. So as we know that the rib case, the muscles present between the ribs and as well as this diaphragm has been contracted, so that the size of the chest cavity is increases, so that inside the air pressure will decrease or increases? Inside air pressure will decreases. So that what is happening? The outside air is having much air pressure, so that immediately the outside air will be rushes into the chest. Do you understanding, Ra?
Okay.
No. So that is what will happen during breathing in. So now, if it comes to the breathing out, what will happen, Ra? They will again will relax. So relaxation state, what is happening? These muscles, the muscles present between the rib cage, will be moving inwards and out it is.
Downwards.
Downwards and inwards, and diaphragm is relaxing state. It is going to which direction? Upward. Correct or not? So that the chest cavity size will decreases or increases? Chest cavity size increases or decreases? So the chest cavity size will decreases, so that the inside air pressure will increases much, so that it has been rushes into outside from inside to outside. Did you understand, all of you? Yes or no? That is what the mechanism is. It yes or no? So like that, this process of breathing in and breathing out will takes place when the air pressure will be varies from outside to inside, breathing in and breathing out, inside to outside. Any doubt, anybody please ask. Okay, so, and also you may remember in last class I have taught you that alveoli has been sticked to the blood vessels. Is it yes or no? Please let you speak means it will be good. It is not. So many need to join still. Please make a call for them. Jesse is not there. Pranita is not there. Jesse, are you there? Make a call, somebody. Pranita, Humaira, do you understand? Humaira, Arya, Dilipan.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Be active. Don't sleep. Now you see. So as we know that now air is reaches to the which part? Exchanging, where the gaseous exchange will take place. What called
alveoli?
What is that alveoli or air sacs?
Air sacs.
When we breathe in, the air sacs or alveoli of the lungs gets filled with what? Air which containing oxygen rich. Is it yes or no? Oxygen rich air will be reaches to the alveoli. Now, these alveoli are surrounded by a very, very, very thin blood vessels, which we used to call as capillaries. What we used to call them? Capillaries. That is what you should note it down. Understand? So they have been containing a very thin blood vessels called as capillaries, which will carrying blood in them. So they are bringing the blood to the alveoli. That is what you should remember. So that point all of you note it down. So alveoli are surrounded by a thin blood vessels called as capillaries. C-A-P-I-L-L-A-R-I-E-S, capillaries, a thin blood vessels called as capillaries. What is the functioning of capillaries, anybody? What is the use of capillaries?
To bring the oxygen and the blood,
understanding, write it, all of you. The alveoli are surrounded by a very thin blood vessels, this is the point you should remember, and the functioning is most important. Thin blood vessels called capillaries which carrying blood in them. Do you understanding, all of you? What is the functioning of capillaries, Dina? Everybody note it down, Pranav. Functioning of capillary. Okay? Padmavarshini is yes, also sir. Not there. Please make a call to her. Somebody call the absentees. You people know, correct? Just 1 minute you take it and you call it. So that is what the functioning of capillaries. So these alveoli are just attached with this capillary so that they will bring the blood near to them. They will carry the blood to them. So as we know that once the blood will reach us, what will happen? The oxygen of air diffuses out from the alveoli walls into the blood. That is what will happen. What will happen here? The oxygen air, what is happening from the alveoli to it will be blood. The air diffuses, which air? Oxygen air diffuses into the blood, so that from there what is happening, it will be spreading throughout the body. Be understanding, all of you?
Body.
Understand? So once this oxygen of air is diffuses inside, understand, diffuses out from the alveoli walls into the blood, then this oxygen is carried by blood to all the parts of the body. So that is what we can say. Oxygen is carried by a red pigment, which I already taught you, which is present in our body. What we should call that? Which is present in the blood?
Hemoglobin.
So the oxygen is carried by blood, means in the sense of who is carrying actually hemoglobin. What is that?
Hemoglobin.
H-A-E-M-O. Hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is the pigment which has been present in our human blood. So understand, which has been carried the oxygenated blood throughout to the body. Is there any doubt, anybody? Please tell me. So till here over. Now, oxygen is diffuses into the each part of the body. So as we know, so once this oxygen is reached to the, carried by the pigment called as hemoglobin, which is present in the blood. So as we know, as the blood passes through the tissues of the body, means each and every cell of the body, the oxygen present in it diffuses into the cell because of higher concentration of the blood. Because that blood is having more oxygenation, means higher concentration. So the cells is having low concentration of oxygen. So that from higher concentration to lower concentration, the oxygen will diffuses. So later what is happening? The oxygen combines with the what? That digestive process, you may remember, yesterday also I have asked you, aerobic respiration, that oxygen which is present, which has been diffuses into the cell, has been, what is happening? Already something has been carried by the blood. What is that? Digestive food. What is that? Digestive food. What will happen? Digestive food, most probably what it contains? Digestive food. Oxygen is reached to the cells. It has been reacted with the digestive food, which we used to call it as what? Glucose. Is it yes or no? Respiration process will start. Correct or not?
Yes. So
they used to react with the oxygen. Once it will be diffuses from higher concentration to lower concentration. Where higher concentration oxygen? Oxygen is where is higher concentration? So in blood it is higher concentration. Concentration is more.
Blood.
So higher concentration. So it will be diffuses into the cells or tissues. So tissues where it is having low concentration. Do you understand? Low concentration of oxygen. So that from the blood to the tissues, the oxygen will be what process? It will be transferred by what process? Diffusion. Understanding? By the diffusion. Oxygen is transferred from oxygenated blood to the tissue. So here tissues, we already having a digested food, which we used to call it as what? Which we used to call it as what? Glucose. So this glucose will release what? Both the reaction will take place. They will release the, what it is called as? Energy plus carbon dioxide plus water. Is this or no? Okay. So they will release us, that is. So energy has been useful to our body and it has been stored in the form of, what is the energy cells in our body? Yesterday I have asked that question. What is the energy cells in the body?
ATP.
What is ATP full form? What is ATP full form?
Adenosine triphosphate.
Once this blood passes through these tissues of the body, the oxygen present in it will start diffuses in it because of always it will travel from high concentration to low concentration. So as we know that blood is concentration in the blood is higher, so that it has been diffuses into the cells or tissues. So this oxygen will combines with the digested food present in the cells to release energy. So as we know, when the main purpose is to carry the respiration reaction is to produce energy, along with that we used to get the byproducts called as what? Carbon dioxide gas as well as water. So water has been used by our body only for other biological purposes, and the carbon dioxide gas, which is produced as a waste product during respiration. Carbon dioxide is called as what? Waste product or unnecessary product. which has been very poisonous. Carbon dioxide is the waste product which has been produced during what?
Respiration.
During respiration. So there is no functioning of carbon dioxide inside our body. Is it as? So that
yes, sir.
We have to kick it outside. We cannot store it inside because carbon dioxide level increases, so that it may lead to the death or suffocation. So there is no use of it. So we have to kick it outside again. We have to breathe out. That's all. So what is happening? Which is producing during this carbon and during this respiration in the cells of the body tissues, these carbon dioxide again will start. Now, who is higher concentration? Carbon dioxide higher concentration is who? Higher concentration, CO2 higher concentration. Higher concentration is where? More. It is in tissues, correct or not? So tissues, it is more in concentration. So from tissues to it will be diffusing into where? It will be diffuses into where? Lower concentration of carbon dioxide, which is called as what? So higher concentration, CONC dot is the shortcut of concentration. You have to remember it. So lower concentration, it will start diffusing back, man. You have to communicate. Reverse process will begin. So the carbon dioxide which has been produced, which will be again diffuses into higher concentration of tissues to lower concentration of blood. So now again this blood will be carried to where? Back process. You start now. Back process. Where it will come to the blood? Blood will comes to where? This carbon dioxide diffuses into the blood from the higher concentration in the body tissues, which will be carried back to where? Carbon dioxide rich blood will be carried back to where? I won't speak. You will say only I will speak. Carried back to? Where it will come again? It needs to breathe out, correct? So that where should come? Then what is the use of teaching? You can close that. No use. Where they will come back again? It will comes to the lungs only, correct? Lungs only again the process will be sending out. Then why you are not answering? So it will be carried back to the lungs where it will diffuses into the alveoli. So as we know, middle one mediator is there who can exchange the gases. What is that name called as? What is that name called as? Alveolus has been connected with some kind of a tissues, which is called as a very thin blood vessels, which we used to call as what? Thin blood vessels, which we used to call as what?
Capillaries.
See, already I have taught you where the exchange of gases will take place, both the gases, where it will take place? At the alveolus. Alveoli are the parts of a lungs where the exchange of gases will take place. So oxygen has been exchanged from the alveoli to the blood with the help of a blood vessels called as capillaries, who will carry the blood to the alveoli. Means the oxygen has been given out, diffuses out from the capillaries to the blood from the alveoli. That is what is happening. Now the reverse reaction is happening. So again the blood is bringing the carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide reaches to the capillaries, blood vessels. So this capillaries will give it to the what? Again, they will give it to the
alveoli.
They will give it to the alveoli. That is what I am asking. Then why you are not speaking? Now it will reaches to the alveoli. So now alveoli means during that time what is happening? Our chest size will be less or more? It is decreases or increases? It will be decreases or increases? Chest size will be decreases because we have to send it outside so that our diaphragm and as well as the muscles present between the ribs, they will be relaxing stage, so that downwards and inwards they will move, and as well as diaphragm will move upwards, so that the rib cavity size, chest cavity size will decreases. So what is happening? The carbon dioxide concentrated air has been kicked outside. Is it yes or no?
Yes, sir.
That is what the process which we have studied, breathing out. So once this carbon dioxide back to the lungs, where it is diffuses into the alveoli. So when we breathe out air, this diaphragm and the muscles attached to the ribs, they will relax due to which our chest cavity contracts, our chest cavity contracts and becomes smaller. So if it is become smaller means where the carbon where the air pressure is more, anybody, where the pressure of air is more? Nitish, Nitinath, if the chest cavity is smaller, outside air is more pressure or inside air is more pressure? Where it is pressure is more, pressure is higher? Are you understanding or not? You tell me that is first. If you are very silent, then I cannot teach.
Yes, inside, sir.
Inside is more. So that what is happening? It has been understanding, sending outside. It has been breathed out. That's all. That is what is happening. So now, please reverse process. Tell me what is that? Let me see who is remembering all the parts. Now, the carbon dioxide rich blood, rich air has been reached to the alveoles. Now, alveoles to what next? Where it will reach us? Reverse process, you tell me. Where it will reach us?
Blood.
Where it will
blood.
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 Again, blood what? From blood only, carbon dioxide reaches to the alveoli. Now, reverse I am asking. Breathing out. It will be reaches to the alveoli. Alveoli is to branchiole, which has been smaller tube.
Branchiole.
It will reaches to where? It will reaches to the branchus. Next, branchus to? Windpipe to nasal cavity, nostrils. It has been pushed out. I am asking reverse process. You cannot remember that?
Sir.
That is what? Branchioles. Dina is saying branchioles, branchus, trachea, nasal cavity and nostrils. That's all. Very good, Dina. That is what it is happening in reverse process. Arya, do you understanding, Arya? Pranav? Yes or no?
Sir.
Two classes I am teaching this. And if you are not understanding, if you are unable to explain this, I cannot do anything. That is what I am saying to you. So, once they will be in relaxing state, so the mechanism is most important. So, the concentration of movement of the chest, it will be this because of the contraction, the carbon dioxide rich air has been pushed out. Movement, the chest will push us out carbon dioxide from the alveoli of the lungs into the where it is trachea, nostrils and then out of the body into the air. So in this way, the process of gaseous exchange is completed in human respiratory system, going inside and going coming outside, breathing in and breathing outside. That is what I said, the mechanism is most important. So that during this breathing cycle, when air is taken in, is also called as what? Air is taken in. What we should call? Inhaling. Is it yes or no?
Inhaling.
And let out, we used to call it as exhale. The lungs always contain certain residual volume of air. You always remember, lungs will never become empty. Always they have some amount of air which is present in the lungs. Only concentration will be varies. So that is why they will get a sufficient time for the exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide. Means oxygen to be absorbed into the blood, for the carbon dioxide has been released from the blood. So this is what, why it is happening. Always they have a sufficient enough understanding. Residual. What is the meaning of residual? Residue means wastage, like we can say. Residue means something has been deposited. Like that, some amount of air is always deposited in lungs. Understanding? Residual volume of air.
Yes.
Residual. Always remember this word. Residual volume of air is present in the lungs to exchange of, to diffusing the oxygen into the blood, and as well as same way carbon dioxide has been released during respiration and again it has been brought by the blood to the alveoli. So they have a enough sufficient time to take place this process. So that is why immediately you can see oxygen is going inside, carbon dioxide is coming outside, oxygen is going inside, coming outside, because we have already some stored air which is present inside the lungs, residual volume of oxygen air, so that which has been absorbed by the capillaries, which has been carried by the hemoglobin to the cells, respiration process will be carried out, carbon dioxide will be brought back by the blood, and this blood the carbon dioxide to the alveoli, so alveoli to branchioles, branchioles to where? Branches, branches to the windpipe or trachea, and trachea to nasal cavity, and nasal cavity to nostrils. Is it yes or no? Yes.
Yes, sir.
fall will happen. Yes, so like this, the exchange of gases is taking place. So there is a sufficient time to exchange these gases. That is why it is, we are feeling that it is fast, it is taking place. But actually some residual volume of air is there inside the lungs. That is why it is happening this much faster. So, and also one more point you should remember. The carbon dioxide is more soluble in water, more than oxygen. You may people think that oxygen is more soluble in water, but carbon dioxide is even more than oxygen it will be solved. That is why mostly it will be transported in the dissolved form in our blood. Please all of you remember, it is always transported cells or tissues to our alveoli in the form of dissolved state. Do you understanding all of you? Because it can be easily soluble in water, because our blood contains major percentage is water only.